Okay. After installation, this GMD-60 will be like that. Okay. Okay. When we deliver to you, the feeding vessel will be disassembled. The motor will be disassembled. And the vacuum system will be disassembled also. Let me show you how to use it. First step, you should make sure all the valves is closed and the whole system is sealing well. Okay, please remember when you installation, when you install this flange connection, should be not too tight, too close. When you find a seam, when you find a seam appear, it means that this part sealing well. Okay. Yeah, the seam is okay. If you make it so tight, then it will be broken. So be careful. Okay, let me show you. First step, make sure the power connection. Okay, the power connection is okay here. Then open the switch here. Okay, diffusion pump. Okay. Okay, please make sure the pump valve is closed before you start. Okay, let we use this time to introduce the gauge. Okay, this is the vacuum gauge. This is the vacuum sensor here. This is the temperature meter. This temperature is measure the temperature sensor here. This is temperature sensor here. This temperature sensor should be matched with the heating pad when you use. This connection is the diffusion, the vacuum pump power connection mount. And now we don't connect it. Before we deliver it, we will connect it to this mouse. Okay. Later, I will show you all the connection. Okay, first step. We start the diffusion pump open. And then we should wait 5 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. until this process is finished. Okay, during this time, we can introduce how to use the circulator here. Okay, this is the heater for the feeding vessel. Please make sure the connection input and output is due like we show to you. Okay. Because our power is limited, I can't start the circulate or the circulate at the same time. But just show you. Okay. Before you press this, then you will find a button behind. Okay. Behind this. Behind, okay? Press it. Okay, press it first. Then, here. One, loop. Then loop. Loop. Then, hit. You can set the temperature here, like this. Set. This button is to move the change position. And this is for increase, this is for decrease. After you set the temperature you want, you can press this. Okay? Please be sure that first step, the behind power button and this power loop hit. Okay. The distillation. This is the heater for distillation. Okay, the operation process is the same as the secondary heater here. Please make sure the connection like this. Okay. This is the main heater. Out. In. Out. Make sure. Make sure. Out. And in. Okay. Okay, you can see, out, in. Okay, 4 minutes. Okay. The same, okay. This is the chiller for the external condenser. Okay, you should also make sure the connection is correct. In, out. In, out. Okay. Then, let's start the diffusion pump. No. Okay, let's start the diffusion pump. Okay. this vacuum pump, the power. This power. Doesn't go away. Open the gate cluster. And then this valve. You should pull like this. And that. Come to do the ramping, and you will see the vital gauge here. During this time, I will show you the connection behind. Okay, this is a heat power. You should connect yourself, okay, and this will be your line. Heat power. This is the motor power. This is the motor power. The motor power, okay? Motor power connected like this. Okay. And this tube is the temperature sensor to match with the heating bath. You can wrap the heating bath. Here and here or here to keep warming, avoid jam. Now we check the that we check the vacuum gauge now. Okay, this is all the surface definition machine we are producing. Show you the population work, the regular. Okay. Okay, you can sense a heat. And this is the...
Have it down. Okay.
Okay. Look down. Look down. Close the wiping system. Look down. Close here. Close the diffusion valve. Okay. Close. Now close this the well. Okay. Okay, and you can see the dropping fan, the light is means it is still working, because the diffusion pump needs about 15 minutes to cooling. Okay.